So yeah, shout out to Black History Month, shout out to the African American poets, shout out to the poets in general, shout out to pens and pads and DJs, shout out to Georgia, we got Georgia in the house tonight. So, he being stingy with the tricks right now, but he got some tricks up his sleeve. Don't worry, y'all. Okay, here comes the trick.
Hi. Hi, guys. Hi, guys. Thank you. Is it just me or can no one hear him anymore?
I can't hear the music either.
They pause the music. What happened to the music?
Okay. Hello. Okay. Everything goes out. I don't know what happened.
That's unfortunate. I'll play. Actually, no, I don't want to play. If no one else wants to. Okay, John, you do it.
Hello, I'm John or Johnny.
I'm back.
Can I read some poetry?
Can you guys hear me?
Hold on.
Yeah, we can hear you now. The music went out. And you went out as well.
Okay. Mic check. Whoa. Please tell me to save.
I think we can hear you now.
Okay. All right. Can you guys hear me? Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. All right. Okay. So we have a dope feature for tonight. Thank you guys for jamming with us, vibing with us. Yeah, I know it's a lot going on outside. So shout out to you guys for just, you know, coming to be a part of this. Whether you're speaking or supporting, just thank you for being here. All right. So our dope feature for the night is K Bale. And if you can, K Bale, can you drop your website in the chat? I am K Bell. So simple. Okay. Awesome. So that's her website, and she's a super dope poet. I ended up finding her on Poets and Writers, so check them out as well. And yeah, Kate Bell is the author of two collections of poetry, Cry, Sweat, Bleed, Write, and Diary of an Intercessor. Oh, both of those received awards. So she received the Lilly Poetry Review Books of 2020 and the Diary of an Intercessor, Finishing Line Press 2021. A member of the Harlem Writers Guild, she received her MFA from the City College of New York, where she was the 2015 recipient of the Esther Unger Poetry Prize and the 2018 co-recipient of the David Dortort Prize in Creative Writing for Nonfiction. Kay's poetry has appeared in numerous venues, including the Ekphrastic Review, The Right Launch, Pithead Chapel, and the book Brown Molasses Sunday, an anthology of Black women writers. She lives in the South Bronx and is passionate about bringing the arts back to public schools and issues that affect marginalized communities. Let's give it up for Kay Bell.
Hi, everyone. Thank you, Rayanne, for that lovely introduction. How's everyone doing today?
Hi.
Good. So I'm going to read you guys I'm going to read you guys a couple of poems from my new book,
Diary of an Intercessor. And both of my books can be found on Amazon.com or Barnes & Noble's online. The first poem I'm going to start with, because we are commemorating Black History Month, because Black History Month is every month. I'm Black all day, every day, 365 days a year. So I'm going to be reading some poems that discuss the Black experience from many different lenses. The first poem I'm going to read is called Do Not Resist. Two Black men, one uniformed, one in jeans, a tee, a torn do-rag, and retro blue Jordans. The uniform presses against the tee and the cotton retreats, four hands resting against a gate. Sweating brows, uttering prayer, masculinity marred. Someone's phone falls to the sidewalk. Someone screams help. Someone's breathing has braked. Someone's belly growls. Someone's now calling for backup. And everyone's watching, even my son, who has nearly finished his chocolate milk. Do not resist, says one man. But the other man has conquered his own Black flesh and breaks free. The uniform runs after him, but only catches a do-rag. So this next poem is actually dedicated to one of my favorite muses, Langston Hughes, and it's called America. I think I may know a little bit about your dreams deferred and damaged, turning themselves around and around like magic. Cause like you, America was never America to me either. I have imagined what it would have been like if this land, which supposedly is mine and yours and everyone else that looks like us, would have been a land of freedom or real democracy. And something besides just a little girl's imagination. Oh, what a world it would be. But I guess I have some of those basic dreams too, the ones that spin around and around and kind of go nowhere, even the ones that seem to play themselves out unexpectedly. And like you, I wonder, is there any land where we are all free from the emotional and physical entanglement of a dream deferred? Cause I am too tangled, stretched, and called ugly. But like you, I won't stop dreaming. You see, cause we never dream in vain. And if we allowed America to defer our dreams, it would really make me wonder who is it that we're dreaming for anyway? We the people are the people who hold our own dreams, and they don't always have to be in our tears and sorrows. Mine are in my legs because I'm walking with victory. So they can call me ugly. Most of the time they can't say it to my face. And even if they did, my America is the dream the dreamers dreamed. And there's nothing ugly about that.
Yes, yes.
Yes, poet.
Okay, so Rayan, I don't know, how many poems do you want me to read?
The whole book. No.
But then you guys would never buy it.
Read the one for your brother.
Okay, no. I'll read one for my brother. This tends to be a favorite. This one is called We Are Loners. You told mommy you hated her today, but I knew that was a lie. You held that Heineken bottle tightly, like your nephew clinging to his favorite blanket. Your sturdy hands were shaking, and I witnessed the privacy of your afflictions in your dialect and sweaty forehead. There's a story to tell. I promise one day I will tell the world that all the odds were against you, and that Barbados raised you alone. I will not leave out the flawlessness of your swaying body against cartel tunes or the codfish and rice with lentils in the winter. The liability isn't all yours. I know the pain rides you, but we are loners, brother. We live in a land where we must honor thy mother and thy father, or we won't live long enough to see our tears trace the city like bridges. There are no morals to your story, only a restricted beginning, forging an appetite for women and children with hostilities. But you are not the prodigal son. You are a father and brother rising before day to iron your clothes and begin your hustle, because the early bird catches the worm, and you are destined to fly above lifeless expectations, speaking only the language of the stars. You were never an illusion or a fiasco. You have not failed. When you spoke to mommy today, those lies didn't bandage my revelations. You wanted to be held, for real. But instead, you drank your Heineken and sat down. Mommy sobbed in the corner, and I smoked a cigarette at the table while our sister was yelling something about telling you to leave as our children were asleep in the back room. Who will tell your story? There are Beijing dreams dying on the inside of a man. There are remnants of his nightmares staring his nostalgic sorrows. Marijuana-stained secrets relating to his insensible one-night stands, and there are people walking by doing nothing. We are loners, brother. We rip the flesh off bones of truth. There are hills in our backs and jungles in our souls. We walk on frayed ankles, born as Beijing pariahs and American misfits. We scream quietly. We know no mothers or fathers or the love that comes in between. No one understands us. I sung a Black girl song today, but tomorrow I vow I will tell your story. Thank you.
Woo! We all have a story.
That was beautiful.
Right? I feel like it's important for us to uplift and encourage each other. Yeah, so I dropped K-Bell's link in the chat. So if you guys can support her by any means necessary, you know, promote her work, hit her up on Instagram, on Facebook. I'm not sure what other platforms she may have. Purchase a book. I know I got to get me one. Do you have a couple more pieces that you can share? And then we'll get to the open mic list.
I can read one more. I'll read one that I wrote for my son, because what's Black History Month without Black sons? Okay, this one I wrote for my oldest son, Zaire, and it's called Constructing a Dream. You take the cereal boxes away from their fate and you fill them with purpose. They come alive as trains, elevators, sometimes an emotional mother. And as a city is built in your youth and virtue, you seize its possibilities, taking all the risks to inspire an old moon to harvest great beginnings. I carried you once, 4 pounds of growing belly. My heart burned and I was alone, but not really. You stroked my maternal eyes and made me something. Each time I tried to convince myself I was better off dead. Now I buy the family-sized boxes of cereal, the ones with extra room for seats and passengers who bear sons of their own. Sons who are faithful to the occupation of unconditional love. And because I am so clumsy and sensitive, I often crush the corner of the rectangular packages before I get them home. But you say, Mama, I will use it anyway. And I cry in private as you go in your room and build us both a dream. Thank you. So again, that all of these poems is from my book, Diary of an Intercessor. Thank you for listening, guys.
Yes, thank you so much for joining us. I'm going to drop your website in the chat and your book on Amazon as well. And you're on Barnes & Noble too, right?
Yes, My first book, Cry, Sweat, Bleed, Write, that one is on Amazon and Barnes and Nobles. And my last book is on Amazon, but both books can also be published by the publisher, which is all found, all that information is found on my website, imkbell.com.
Awesome. So are there any other words of encouragement that you want to drop? You know.
I just want to say that I thank you, Rayanne, for having this event. And I love this idea of just reminding us that, you know, we're Black History Month is every month. And I think that is important because I think that sometimes a lot of these movements gain momentum for a season, but we have to remember that we have to keep educating ourselves, keep supporting one another, keep encouraging one another, and most importantly, keep writing and bringing awareness to a lot of the issues that we face. So thank you, Rayanne, and thank you for everyone for supporting the event.
Yes, yes. I'm so appreciative to have had you just, you know, bless the stage, and let's definitely do this again. Definitely, for sure. I'm down.
Absolutely.
Yes. You guys be sure to check her out on Amazon, on Barnes and Noble. Check out her website. And if you guys can, now's the time to unmute your mic and give it up for the future Kate Bell. Woo! Woo! Yes.
Awesome. Beautiful work.
Yes. Wonderful.
That was amazing.
People really are really committed. I can tell you're very committed. I really appreciate your work, K-Bell.
It's awesome.
Can I just add, so in this spirit of the you know, Black History Month being every month, I wanted to just add that this that we started in 2015, the decade of African descent. And we are almost at the end of it. So 2015 to 2024 was designated by the UN as this the decade of African descent. You guys can Google it and look it up to see what else it entails. But each year was had some kind of dedication to people of African descent. So in that same vein.
Thank you.
And I also got a question for Kay. You know, first and foremost, I love your work. Your work is beautiful. One of my favorites is the one for your brother. Also, the poet, the one Harlem in your first book is one of my favorites as well. What is Black history to you? What does it mean to you as an individual? Like, what do you want to accomplish and give others in Black history? Like, how would you, you know, say that?
Rayanne, do we have time for me to answer that?
Yes, if you...
Okay, I'm sorry. I don't want to take up anyone's time. But Black history for me is all about resilience. Since, you know, the beginning, we have been storytellers. And so for me, Black history is all about telling those stories, telling our stories of survival. More importantly, our stories of resilience and strength. And I think that what a lot of people don't realize is that Black people in general are very diverse people. And those stories come in all different flavors. And so it's just really important for me as a Black woman to be able to tell my stories. And, you know, sometimes share the stories that I've experienced through the eyes of others. So I hope that answers your question.
Yes, definitely. Thank you.
Yes. I think it's amazing as artists is that we can tell our story, but it's also relatable. You know, like you're telling your story and like, I feel that, like, you know, like, I just feel like we mesh. So shout out to you for just having that voice and telling your story, but so many other African-American women, their story as well, you know, that's a gift and a talent. So thank you. And shout out to Malcolm for that question.
Yeah, I have a poem for Women's Appreciation Month that I want to do. You know, I spent a little time on it, and I just want, you know, to get some feedback. It goes, raised from birth in much due and respect to my sisters. Sisters, thank you for that untouchable love, my true soulmate, and I'll never sell out. My true love is in your blackness, forever remaining someone to cherish, to console, and to be there for. Sisters, it's your time, and I'm thankful for Women History Month. So much to say. You've sacrificed so much diligently. I am at your side, as you are like my closest friend, my confidant, my silent warrior who brings me much confidence. Our relationship so close, so meaningful as we support each other. Sisters, your everlasting hope for me to be a better man moves me onward. Your timeless sayings and soulful gestures make the man in me strong and intelligent. Beside you, I am fearless, and your red, black, and green corridors of brutal ecstasy magnetize me with the light of our true destiny. Straightforward, I care for your strength. Emotion through you, I gain to go the length. Convinced about you, conceited, it's true. Any disrespect, protect, I will endure. Your mighty character building me up every day, shining a light sometimes when I don't see the way. There's my strong sister. There isn't much you haven't seen, so redemptive, truly fit for a king. I'll never sell out again and be about another nationality, no doubt. We fit together through whatever the Lord brings us. Chime me in as your perfect mate. God is on time and never late, as you have a month for your appreciation. I hope it's been good in relation. I couldn't imagine going through what you've been. I hope it's not too long till Women History Month is and appreciation is again.
Sisters.
God is on time and never late.
Thank you, Word.
Thank you, Anne.
Thank you.